Keep watching Charis TV.
Just write faith.
But
make it a bracket.
Bracket.
And say, do not surrender.
That
is faith for you. You don't surrender. You who have got faith will never surrender. The first thing faith needs individuals. Assurance. It does not need anybody. That is why everybody will stand before God alone. Faith is assured from your heart. Expressed by your mouth. Assured from your heart. Faith here. Is an inherent trust. And confidence in the power of God.
Yes.
So it becomes very simple now. That if I don't have endurance, it means I'm out of faith. It becomes simple that if I'm speaking something today, tomorrow, I change. I'm not of faith. Things from God. They won't just come automatically. God have to look at us and see if we are fit for what he wants to give us. The promises. His promises are yes and amen, but there have to be a price you pay. The price you pay is faith. So Hebrews 12 verse 2.
Faith
does not involve your sight. If truly faith involves your sight, it's no longer faith.
Because
it does not have hope. As a child of God, you do not need to surrender. Faith to you tells you that you do not need to surrender. Look away from this distraction. 1 Peter 5:9.
This is the
enemy of your faith.
Is Satan. Satan.
There is no way Satan can come to you except to deal with your own faith. When he comes to you, he is there to nullify your faith.
There
are two things that happen. When your faith is affected, either it decreases or it divides. You find that your faith started to have fear. It can decrease and become small. Or it just divides. And from there, it becomes useless. Fear starts to be part of you. With a divided mind. And the Bible says such person will never receive anything. Are you seeing opposition? Resist and stand firm in your faith. Are you sick? Resist and stand firm in your faith. Are you having challenges? Resist and stand firm in your faith. Can you tell your neighbor again? Resist and stand firm in your faith. Look at this, Romans 8:18. For you to be spiritual, look at the situation at the standpoint of your faith. A spiritual person, it's a faith man. Let me say it again. A spiritual person is a faith man. Whatever you see manifesting in reality are coming from the spirit. When you are going through a problem, I'm standing and I'm viewing the situation as a spirit man, a man of faith. When I look at it, I'm seeing it the way God wants me to see it. If God doesn't want me to change it by prayer, let me go through it. There are some things are
there as programmed for us. Whether you like it or not, you go through that. You must consider things at the standpoint of faith. The moment you move by faith, no one will compete you. God will block them and put them there until you reach where you are going. Everything that God wanted to do, there is opposition. Don't stop because of opposition. I said, don't stop because of opposition. You must know, you must stand, because the devil wants to take your faith away. James 5 verse 13. Persistent prayer. A prayer that cannot be affected. A prayer that does not have doubt. It's a prayer of a person with good faith.
Faith.
You know, it's not supposed to be something like of exchanging. It must be constant. It must be something that continues without stopping, without doubt. Matthew 21. Read from verse 18 to 22. Don't change prayer because you are seeing nothing.
Oska change tapelo ka ubana ubona usa chishinye isilo.
Because faith here shows that it will happen.
Dito dirahala.
I don't know how I can explain
it.
To me, it seems to be difficult. It's, let me show you by my Bible here. And give it to someone. Can you see this Bible?
Amen.
Come on, brother, come here. Look at this brother. I'm giving you the Bible. What happened to you? Do you have the Bible?
Yes.
You have the Bible. Is what happened in the spirit. When you ask anything in the spirit, you receive it same time. Are you hearing me? But now, what you have received in the spirit, it creates the physical. To be seen in the physical. In other words, stand here, my brother. This Bible, when this man have it, before you see it, he knows he have it. When you started to say congratulations to him, this is not new. He knows he will have it. We need Christians who knows that they are going to receive. So the Bible says you will receive, but you have it by faith. You have it by faith, and you will receive it in the physical. Matthew 17.
Read
verse 14. We need to know the will of God upon our lives. We might be praying for things that are not happening because it's not God's will. We need to ask God, is it your will? I have faith, but is it your will? Even Jesus prayed that prayer. Let it be your will.